Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss the third colligative property, that is depression in freezing point. So what do you mean by the freezing point? First, so the freezing point is defined as it is the temperature at which the solid and the liquid states of the substance have same vapor pressure, that is called freezing point. Okay, before formation of a solution, let us take only the solvent. That solvent can exhibit certain vapor pressure at a particular temperature. As the temperature is decreases, slowly the vapor pressure of that solvent is decreases. By reaching a particular temperature, that solvent is started the freezing. At whatever the temperature it starts the freezing, so in that situation both the solid and the liquid states of that substance exhibit same vapor pressure. So that is the temperature is called freezing point of that solvent. But here when we are added the non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent, generally the vapor pressure of a solution is decreases. As a result, the freezing point of the solvent is also will be decreases. That means the freezing point of a solution is less than that of the solvent. Whereas in the case of the boiling point, the boiling point of a solution is increases when we are adding the non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent. But here, the freezing point of the solution is decreases. So, how much it is decreases, that is we call as here depression in freezing point. So, what we are giving the statement here, when a non-volatile solute is dissolved in volatile solvent freezing point of solvent decreases. So that means that what we say that decreases means the freezing point of solution is less than that of solvent. How much it is less than, that is we called as here depression in freezing point. This is called depression, that is a decreases of freezing point, depression in freezing point. That is, we can express mathematically if freezing point of pure solvent is T0F freezing point of solution is Tf, then depression in freezing point is, we write I's mathematically, delta Tf is equal T naught F minus Tf, because solvent is greater than that of solution, that's why T naught F minus Tf. Or normally in some of the textbook they might be mentioned delta Tf is equal T naught minus Ts. So that's why this is might be represented with T naught, or this is Ts. So depression in freezing point is equal to the difference between the freezing point of pure solvent to the freezing point of solution containing the non-volatile solute. Here one important point is, the depression in freezing point delta Tf is always inversely proportional to the freezing point of solution. So why the depression in freezing point is inversely proportional to freezing point of a solution? Let us take solution 1 and solution 2. So in both the cases the solvent is common, say whose freezing point is T naught, and the freezing point of the solution is Ts. Let us take the water is a solvent. Water is freezes at which one? 0 degree centigrade. Here also water, 0 centigrade. The quantity of a solute is different from solution 1 to solution 2. So now your freezing point of a solution is less than the freezing point of solvent, say for example 2 degree centigrade minus. Here minus 3 degree centigrade. Then what is delta Tf value here? That is 0 minus of minus 2, so that 2 degree centigrade. So here 0 minus of minus 3, that is 3 degree centigrade. Now let us see here, as the freezing point of a solution is decreases from minus 2 degree centigrade to minus 3 degree centigrade, it is decreases, the freezing point of a solution is decreases, the depression in freezing point is increases from 2 degree centigrade to 3 degree centigrade. That's why the depression in freezing point of solution is always inversely proportional to freezing point of a solution. If the freezing point of a solution is increases, depression in freezing point decreases. If the freezing point of a solution is decreases, the delta Tf value, that is depression in freezing point, is increases. So this is the one important point. Here, when we are adding the non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent, why the freezing point of a solution is decreases? So whenever the pure solvent is present, so the solvent molecules, by decreasing the temperature, so the vapor pressure of the solvent is decreases at a particular temperature, immediately they can be started freezing. So no opposing force is present because it contains only pure solvent molecules. Immediately all the solvent molecules can be undergo a perfect order of arrangement, that will be leads to the freezing. But when we are adding the non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent, so the freezing point of a solution is decreases because of there should be some opposing force for freezing of a solvent molecules with respect to the solute particles. These solute particles move very randomly, So this random movement of the solute particles opposes the freezing point of or the freezing of solvent particles. So to decrease the randomness of this solute particles, only we have to do decrease the temperature. When we are decreasing the temperature, the randomness of solute particles is decreases, the opposing force of with respect to the solute particles are decreases, so that the solvent molecule can easily undergo a perfect order of arrangement that leads to freezing. And that means when we are decreasing the temperature, so the solvent molecules will be undergo freezing in a solution containing the non-volatile solute. So decreasing the temperature is nothing but that is the freezing point of that solution is what happened? Decreases. So that's why when we are adding the non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent, the freezing point of the solution is decreases, because by decreasing the temperature, the randomness of the non-volatile solute particles are decreases. Consequently, the opposing force for the freezing of the solvent particles is decreases. As a result, the solvent particles are ready to undergo freezing. So then it starts the finally it will be freezes. So that means ultimately this entire phenomena is done by decreasing the temperature. That's why the freezing point of a solution is decreases. So this is the term we need to be remember. The depression and freezing point is nothing but the difference between the freezing point of a solvent and the freezing point of a solution containing the non-volatile solute. But whereas in boiling point it is opposite. The difference between the boiling point of a solution and the boiling point of a solvent, that is opposite to the boiling point here. So like how we derive the relation between elevation in boiling point and molality, in the same way we can also derive here the relation between depression in freezing point and molality. See, first let us take the pure solvent. In the pure solvent, the vapor pressure, as the temperature is decreases, the vapor pressure of that solvent is also decreases. At a particular temperature, suddenly there is a steep down in the flat, that is clearly indicates the vapor pressure of the solvent decreases with freezing of solvent. So the solvent is freezes started at this point. This is called the freezing point of a pure solvent. So to this solvent, when we are adding the non-volatile solute, the vapor pressure of a solution is decreases, and we are decreasing the temperature, the vapor pressure is further decreases and reaches this point. By reaching this point, this is in that solution, whatever the solvent is there, that is started the freezing. See here, the temperature is different from the solvent to the solution for freezing. So here this is the temperature and here this is the temperature. Let us take some more amount of a solute is added, then the vapor pressure of the solution is decreases and reaches the point. This is at this point the freezing is started. Now let us see here, when we are, so with respect to this one, the freezing is started for solvent. This is say T naught, and here for solution 1, the freezing point is T1. For solution 2, the freezing point is T2. Say here, this is the point A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H and I. The AB curve represents for solvent, pure solvent. To the solvent, when we are added the non-volatile solute, we get a solution that is named as solution 1. By adding that solution 1, the freezing point of a solution is decreases, because it is moved towards the left. Left is nothing but the freezing point temperature is decreases. I am adding some more amount of a solute, the vapor pressure further decreases with it increasing the temperature, and the freezing point is also will be further decreases to the T2 value, that is T2 is less than T1. Now here clearly indicates from this plot, whenever we are adding the non-volatile solute to the volatile solvent, the freezing point of a solution is decreases. The decrease in the freezing point, how much it decreases, that is we called as here depression in freezing point. Now this AC and A or CF is almost will taken as a straight lines here. Just for deriving the relationship between the depression in freezing point and molality, here we write, let us take the two triangles, the triangles ACD and the triangle AFH. So these two triangles we can concentrate it. With respect to this one, this is the vapor pressure of pure solvent P0. So at this stage, whatever the vapor pressure is there, that is the vapor pressure of solution. And here, this is a vapor pressure of solution 2. Now, here simply from these two triangles ACD and AFH are similar, so that their side ratios are also equal. Their side ratios are equal. So that if here I write as AC by AF is equal, here I write as H G by HF. What is AC? AC is the difference between the pressure P0 minus P1 by, so then AF, that is P0 minus P2. What is HG? That is T0 minus T1 by HF is T0 minus T2. So here this is delta P1, P0 minus P1 is delta P1 by delta P2 is equal depression in freezing point of solution 1 by depression in freezing point of solution 2. And this, from this one, what we write as delta P is directly proportional to delta TF, equation number 1. We know that the relative lowering of vapor pressure delta P by P0 is equal mole fraction of solute. From this one, delta P is equal to P0 into XB, and delta P is directly proportional to XB since P0 is always constant of a solvent. So that is equation number 2. From equation number 1 and 2, what we write is delta TF is directly proportional to XB. So from this one, by removing the constant delta TF is equal to, I write the constant K into XB. This is equation number 3. Where K is a proportionality constant. From thermodynamics, the value of K is, from thermodynamic equation, the K is equal to RT0 square by LF. What is R? R, you know very well, gas constant. What is T0? T0 is freezing point of solvent. What is LF? LF is latent heat of fission. LF is latent heat of fission. Fusion of वन मोल ऑफ सॉल्वेंट, वन मोल ऑफ सॉल्वेंट. सो दैट इज यू कैन सब्स्टिट्यूट इन द इक्वेशन नंबर थ्री, देन व्हाट वी गेट, डेल्टा टी एफ इज इक्वल आर टी नॉट स्क्वेयर बाय एल एफ इंटू एक्स बी. सो here xb is equal to nb by na plus nb, but for dilute solutions what is that, na is 2 greater than nb, that is nb is very very small, that's why Na plus Nb is taken as Na. That's why Xb is equal for dilute solutions Nb by Na. That is, you can substitute in that equation. Delta Tf is equal to Nb by, sorry, Xb plus, what do you write? Nb by Na into Rt naught square by Lf. Just expanding that equation, delta Tf is equal to Rt naught square by Lf into Nb means weight of a solute by molecular weight of solute. What is Na? Wa by Ma, weight of solvent by molecular weight of solvent. Just rearranging this equation, what we get? Delta Tf is equal to Rt naught square by Lf into Wb by Mb into Ma by Wa. So by rearranging that equation, delta Tf is equal to Rt naught square by Lf into Ma into Wb by Mb into 1 by Wa. So now here delta Tf is equal to the above equation, we can multiply and divide it with 1000. Rt naught square by 1000 Lf into Ma into Wb by Mb into 1000 by Wa. So we know that this value Wb by Mb into 1000 by Wa, Wb by Mb into 1000 by weight of solvent, that is A is equal to molality, that is we write as small m. So that I write here delta Tf is equal to Rt naught square by 1000 Lf into Ma into M. This is we write as delta Tf is equal to Kf into M, where Kf is called as cryoscopic constant, cryoscopic constant, or it is also called as molal depression constant, molal depression constant, whose value is Rt naught square by Ma by 1000 Lf. So this is one important equation, delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. So like Kb is the property of solvent, here Kf is also a property of solvent, because since in this equation T naught, Ma and Lf are the properties of solvent, because all are related to the solvent. So Kf is said to be property of solvent. So that means different solvents have different Kf values. So the another important note here, how we can define this Kf, cryoscopic constant, molar depression constant. If M is equal to one molar, then delta Tf is equal to Kf into M. That is, delta Tf is equal to Kf into 1. So that we get delta Tf is equal to Kf. So the cryoscopic constant may be defined as freezing point, the depression and freezing point of which one? 1 molar solution. So therefore, cryoscopic constant may be defined as cryoscopic constant is equal to what? Depression in freezing point of 1 molar solution. Containing non-volatile solute. This is. So like how we determine the molar mass of a solute from the elevation in boiling point or with the help of relative lowering of a pressure. In the same way, here also we can determine the molar mass of a solute from the depression in freezing point. So we know that the relation between the depression in freezing point and molality, that is delta Tf is equal to Kf into molality. But what is molality? Molality is equal to weight of solute by molecular weight of solute into 1000 by weight of solvent. So you write as delta Tf is equal to Kf into, so in the place of molality we write as Wb by Mb into 1000 by Wa. So here we need to determine the molar mass of solute, that is Mb. Mb is equal to Kf into Wb into 1000 by delta Tf into Wa. This is the formula is useful to calculate the molecular mass of a solute, so from the depression in freezing point, where we write as here Kf is, you know very well, cryoscopic constant. It is constant for a given solvent, and W is B. B is represents always solute, that's why it is a weight of solute. So MB is a molecular weight of solute. Molecular weight of solute. And WA is weight of solvent. Delta Tf is equal to depression in freezing point. It is calculated with the help of formula delta Tf is equal to T naught minus Ts. What is T naught? Freezing point of pure solvent, whereas Ts is freezing point of solution containing non-volatile solute. So this is the formula is useful to calculate the molar mass of a solute.